Aloha, I'm Becky Lennon with the Pioneer Inn, and we are proud sponsors of this event, the Maui Plein Air, have been since inception, which I believe was in 2006. I think it's the 10-year anniversary. So we are very pleased to be a part of it once again. We love the fact that it brings artists to Lahaina that would normally be here. We appreciate John Stern and his lecture that he gives tonight that shares with the people of Maui a little bit about art appreciation that we don't get because we don't have big city museums here on Maui. And we just are really thrilled to be a part of it and are proud again to be sponsors one more year.
Aloha, I'm Ann Pistillo and I'm the coordinator for the Mini Painting Silent Auction. This is the third year we've done the auction, and every year the caliber of the paintings just goes up and up. So we're really excited this year for our sale. As you'll notice, a lot of the paintings are relatively small, and the purpose of this auction is for the artists to bring small paintings from home that represent them in their own state or locale. And it gives the artists a chance to show collectors who they are when they're not in Hawaii. We have a lot of paintings this year from California, from Colorado, and of course Hawaii. We ask the artist to bring a painting that's 8x8 or smaller to keep the price down and let people who may not have otherwise been able to buy a painting at our event the chance to purchase a small piece from one of these great artists. We hope you enjoy the show and thank you.
My lecture is entitled The Art of Looking at Art, and it's a basic introduction to what the artist does and how a potential buyer can judge whether or not a painting is well executed. It is important, like in any other discipline, as an art collector, to know what the artist is doing and to know whether or not they're successful at it. Now, the first thing, of course, is you have to love the painting, and that's the most important thing. But it's also reassuring to know that the artist is competent in what they're doing, that they're professional. And the lecture talks about things like drawing, whether or not an object that is being represented actually looks like the object. We also talk about color, the values of color in terms of emotion and in terms of capturing the lifelike effect, natural light. We talk about composition, how the artist controls the eye of the viewer, how they take you through the painting, they show you everything they want you to see, and then lead you out of it again. And then finally we talk about drama, the meaning of a work of art, what the content is, all these things. They're really secondary to whether or not somebody likes a painting or loves a painting and wants to have it, but it's reassuring to know that you need a little more information, you need to know what the artist is trying to do, and you need to determine whether or not that artist is successful and whether that artist is of a professional quality and whether they've done what they set out to do. A silent auction is a way to give everybody a chance at a bargain. Instead of having a fixed price where somebody says, I'll buy it or I won't buy it, it puts a little bit of excitement into the sale. There's a chance that you can buy the painting you want at a lower price than what the artist is intending to sell it for. And the silent auction allows people to bid numerous times, to come back, to look at it again, to see whether somebody else is interested, whether they want to pay a little more. And it gives it a sense of excitement and a little bit of an element of chance. If you love the painting, that's wonderful, but it's always nice to get it at a bargain if you can. And that's what a silent auction affords people.